Hey everybody, it's Vanessa the Crafty Gemini. I'm here in my messy little room at the mini retreat at Missouri Star Quilt Company. I'm about to grab my stuff and head downstairs, and I figured I'd make a quick little video for you. For those of you that can't be here, we are hosting two back-to-back quilting retreats, Jenny Doan from Missouri Star Quilt Company and I, and we just got done with the first one. That one ended the day before yesterday, so we've cleaned out the retreat center and everything. The ladies there and the staff at Missouri Star have gotten everything ready for the second group of retreaters who are just starting to get in here today. So let me show you around. All right, let me close this place up. Let's go see what else there is here in Hamilton, Missouri, which is the headquarters of Missouri Star Quilt Company. All right, so let me make my way down the little street here. The noise you hear is a food truck who's out here selling stuff. I think a lot of different little businesses and stuff try to take advantage of the traffic that Missouri Star brings here to this small town. Should have brought my sunglasses out here. All right, so we're gonna walk across the street and I'm gonna actually show you the different shops that Missouri Star has. Because I think a lot of people, when they get here, where you see the main sign that says Missouri Star Quilt Company, it's the what they call the main shop. But they also have shops that are back here. And these buildings back there, all those different things that you see back there are little shops that they have. Totally jaywalking right now. Pretend. All right, so we're coming across here. This is the retreat center. That's where I'm gonna be a little later. I'll show you guys there also. But you can see there's a mural on the side of the retreat center, and it's really big and gorgeous. Hey! You got some retreaters coming in, parking their cars out here. All right, so we're walking across. It's really small here, so everything is super close. Look at these pretty roses. These things have been blooming since May, because I came up here in May, and every month I come, they're blooming again and blooming again, so super cute. All right, so we got Jay's Burger Dive. That's like fries, burgers. I think they have hot dogs and some ice creams and milkshakes and stuff. And then did you see this? Look at this gorgeous. This is the newest mural they did, and it's of the old train depot that used to run here through town. Let me back up and see. I can't really tell if I'm showing you all the whole thing or not, but let me see if I can fix the camera a bit. It's really cute. And the artist's name is Kelly William Poling. I think that's his, yeah, I think that's his name. And he did both murals, the one, that one, and the other one that I just showed you. So, all right. So let me stand back a little bit and show you the main sign that you guys see when you see Missouri Star Quilt Company. You see that big sign behind me? So that's the main shop, and that's kind of what everybody sees when they get here. So let's go inside and see what we find. All right, so we're in the main shop. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody.
People cutting fabric. We're doing a little video to post today, showing people around town. There's fabric everywhere in here. That's right. You know, one of the retreaters last week brought me this selfie stick, and I'm like, this is perfect. It's not, it has a thing like for the phone, but it also has it for the video camera.
Nice.
Cool, right? Yeah. All right, so let's sneak back here. It says Quilt Diva. Do you guys see this up top? Let me see if I can. Right there. So, wild guess who's in here.
There are no divas in here.
Oh, yeah, right.
No divas in here.
It's Jenny Doan from Missouri Star Quilt Company, and yes, she makes quilts. She still quilts.
I still
she
have still to sew.
Right? You still have to sew.
Dang, what's wrong with this picture? I know.
Say
nice.
Hello, Kelly back there.
Hello.
Working on a quilt as well. You can see they actually make quilts here, guys.
We do.
They're still cranking out their own things. I'm just doing a little video showing them around town. One of the retreaters last week brought me this selfie stick.
Oh my gosh.
And so it's like for the phone, but it holds the video camera too.
Awesome.
Nice and steady. Cool. I'm just showing them around the shop.
I've only done, I've done two selfie stick pictures.
Yeah?
Yeah.
It's a whole new world out there.
I know it is, but it's what you need. I mean, if you don't have anybody else to hold it for you, to be far enough away that you're not, like, right there.
Well, and for some of us, we actually are born with long arms.
Oh.
So we don't need the selfie stick.
That's true. All right, guys. Say bye.
Bye.
I'll see y'all later.
See us again.
All right. Bye. All right. So, tons of fabric everywhere, everywhere. Bolts and bolts of fabric. And the way they do the shops here, let me see if I can show you guys. So everywhere you'll see, in all the shops that I walk around and show you, they have quilts everywhere, obviously. And so when you get here, you can check out the quilts, and they'll say, like, little signs like this that says, I'm a tutorial. And so it says, find me on YouTube, and it gives you the title. So if you come to the shop and you see a quilt that you like this one called the Broken Bars Quilt, then you just, you know, remember the name, take a picture of it, whatever, and look it up when you get home, and that way you'll have access to the tutorial. But this one also says, I'm in Mod Block magazine. So that's the same magazine that my improv tote is in. And it's a cute way to kind of show people quilts and projects that are on display and show them that they, you know, you can pick up the fabric while you're here or by the pattern. Like this one up there has a pattern in a pouch. So you can buy the pattern here as a friendship braid, and it says it's also on the tutorial on YouTube. And this is usually my favorite little section of this shop because let me show you what they have. Cotton and steel, they have tulip pink. They have all kinds of super cute, kind of modern stuff in this corner back here. You see all the gorgeous cotton and steel prints. I love this kind of stuff. The color palette is just gorgeous. And so that's something that they have here, but they have a solid shop that also carries a lot of the more modern prints, like solids and tonals and the cotton and steel basics and stuff. But I mean, there's fabric everywhere. As I walk through, I'm sure you guys are seeing in the background all the different fabric stuff that's in here. But this front side here, you can see, has a bunch of different patterns. And then there's notions and stuff here. And this really cool TV that it's not on right now, but when it is on, they play Jenny's tutorials right on there. A wall of King Tut quilting thread. And usually, if you live close by or if you're visiting, you can come right in here and they have the daily deal posted right in front, so it's the first thing you see when you come into the shop. And that's the main shop. So we'll work our way to the next shop now so I can show you guys what else they have. All right, so they're usually open 9 to 5, but during the summer hours they have longer hours, so they close at 8 o'clock these days. All right, so we're walking. This is a little kind of antique shop. This is not theirs, but it's here on the same strip as the main shop. Now we're gonna walk into the store called Mercantile, and this is like Civil War, 1930s reproduction fabrics, primitives, and stuff like that. So let's walk a little bit around here. All right. So here's a display, and one of Jenny's daughters, Hillary, is the one that does all the windows displays. They're so pretty and super gorgeous. But let me see if I can kind of show you around. You see the fabrics, and you can see this way the different quilts that they have on display here. Hey, y'all. Just doing a video. I'm sorry?
How are you doing today?
Good. How are you?
I'm all right.
Been busy today, huh?
Yeah, we have been.
Yeah.
Okay, that one.
Hi. Excuse me. All right, so you can see all the fabrics. This is like the primitives, Civil Wars, and let's go back here to the 1930s reproductions. These are super cute.
Okay. Is that
all right. And you can see that the shops, they're pretty big. They're kind of long and narrow shops, most of them, but they fit so much fabric into these places. It's kind of crazy. There's always quilts up on the wall. And they sell pre-cuts of whatever the fabric collections are. So like the 1930s reproductions, if they have pre-cut packs, they'll have them in the shop that deals with that. You know, it's not like one separate shop just for pre-cuts. So the pre-cuts go with whatever the collections is and where it belongs in here. But all these fabrics, bolts and bolts and bolts of fabric. All right. So let's go to the next one. This is the only one that for right now is right next to the main quilt shop. The other ones are across the street in front of the retreat center. so let me walk that way and I'll show you those shops.
Okay, we are in what? So seasonal, right?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so these guys here have all the holiday stuff. I can already see this stuff here for Halloween time. They got fat quarter bundles. And of course, there's quilts on all the walls. You got a bunch of really cool Christmas fabrics. They have a bunch of pre-cuts. And they even have some like kind of blenders that will go with the other ones. So if you need like for borders or for binding, hi. So you can see all these bolts. I mean, and I'm only showing you guys the top two. If I tilt this thing down, you can see that there's a whole nother row of fabrics all across the bottom. So there's like a ton of fabrics. Some cute little more novelty looking ones here from Riley Blake. A bunch of pre-cuts. All this kind of stuff. And the Missouri Star template, some patterns. But you guys have the panels too. I have a tutorial for this on how to install the lights in these panels. So you see they sell them here and they sell the LED light kits with it. And the panels, so you guys can install those too. But you can look up a tutorial I have on YouTube for that. And these are all really cute Halloween prints. Oh my goodness, these are so cute. Seriously. Are you guys selling a lot of Halloween stuff or no?
Yes.
More Christmas than anything, I bet.
Well, it actually all depends on the customers. Yeah. Like, they want everything.
Yeah. She's like, I'll have one of everything. That's hilarious. Cool, they got some nice fall fabrics here. And then, of course, the pre-cuts right there in with them.
Do I get an extra inch on every
one? And that's all you see. So you see the holiday stuff. Here's like some July 4th patriotic things for your quilts of valor and stuff like that. They have a bunch of things for that. And that is the So Seasonal shop. So let's work our way to the next one, Batiks. Bye, thanks. All right.
So here we are in the Batik shop and the display on this, I'll show you from the inside, it's so cute. This is my absolute favorite part of this store. Are you ready?
Number four, Mom.
I'm gonna tilt the camera all the way down. You guys gotta see this floor. Ready? So, look at the color of this floor. They like dyed the cement or something. I'm gonna ask exactly what the process was. But it's so pretty. It's like this light blue. And it's showing up darker on camera, but it's so, so cute. And so if you're a Batik fan, this is the place for you. I mean, this is like the most Batiks I've ever seen in one place. And then of course the gorgeous quilts to go with it. It's like the brightest shop. And you can see. How cute is that? The quilting on this one is like peace signs. Let's see if I can show you a close-up. You see the quilt signs on it? I mean the peace signs on it. It's like circles with the peace signs in them in all different sizes. That's super cute. And then of course Batiks in every color that you can imagine. This one actually has four rows. Remember the other shop I showed you all that there were three rows of bolts, but these they're kind of put in on an angle slanted back there so they can fit more bolts, it looks like. Hey. Orders as well?
Yes, I am.
Wowzers. Okay, so these guys got to handle the online orders and they're handling the walk-in traffic, so that's a lot. Is this one of the busier shops, you think? Or?
Not the most busy,
yeah.
Close.
But I think for Batiks, you really get people who are just like obsessed, right? Mm-hmm. Like the diehard Batik fans.
For sure.
Cool. Thanks.
No. It depends on the day.
All right. Oh, let me show you the display before I go. How cute is this display? You can kind of see the display. Well, you can see me in the reflection, but there's kind of see the display of like these glass bottles that have like blue in them and the shells and little twine balls. They're really cute. Hillary does a great job of decorating the shop windows to really go with the theme of whatever the shop is. And that's one of Jenny's daughters that does that. All right, so if you haven't been keeping up with the things going on here at Missouri Star, there's a lot of new things in the work. And let me just show you a sign out here. They basically bought this main street and are gutting out and redoing all these really, really old buildings. And so the sign right here says that this is going to be the future of the man cave. If you take a peek inside here, there's already some huge, like, leather recliner chairs. Is open, so we're gonna take a quick sneak peek in here and show you guys what is going on. Here are some leather recliner chairs, and this is gonna be the man cave. So I can already see a sink that's been put in the back, and so this is gonna be a comfy place for the gentlemen to hang out while their wives, significant others, sisters, mothers, and all that are shopping in the quilt shops, right? So it's gonna be a cool man cave. So now everybody put a visit to Missouri Star on your bucket list and bring the family up here. All right, and then this sign here says this is gonna be the home of the Welcome Center. So they're gonna have a Welcome Center as well. There's a lot of new things going on. I see some new beams that were just put in there. And I think one of those buildings, one of those places is gonna have an elevator. And so now I'm gonna show you all the last two shops here. So this is probably my favorite store. It's the biggest. You can see it says Penny's up here. And that's, it says Penny's Quilt Shop, and they kept it the name like that because this is J.C. Penny's childhood home, like he lived here or something. And so this actual store was the 500th J.C. Penny. That's what it used to be here. And so they kept the sign inside, I'll show you, and so they just call it the Penny's Shop. But in Missouri Star terms, this is their solids and basics shop. So if you're a modern quilter, this is your home. So let's come in here. It's nice and big, brick walls, and they have solids from so many solids. It's really pretty in here. They have some of the notions, kind of a few of the things that they have in the main shop as well. You have like your flatter, your soak, that kind of stuff in here. Some magnetic pin cushions, of course, the templates, Missouri Star templates. This is some solids back here, like fleece. This is wool, actually. Cool, so they sell it by the yard. I didn't see this before, maybe this is new. Or maybe I just didn't see it. Ooh, this is my stuff right here. This is the Crossroads Denim. I love this stuff. So let me give you guys a look at it. This is Crossroads Denim, and I'm working on several tutorials using this stuff. It stitches up like a dream. And I think it comes in like 18 or 19 different colors, and it is absolutely gorgeous. So that's the Crossroads Denim. And this is Robert Kaufman denim in different weights, you can see here. That's a cute one with some polka dot lookalikes on there. And then you have your Bella Solids. This is by Moda Fabrics, the Bella Solids. You can see they start off with the neutrals and they go all the way down that wall to every color you could possibly need. And then of course, the quilts featuring the different fabrics and things like that. They also have the pre-cuts in here of the solids. So let me just work my way around here and show you all what else they carry. So the Bella Solids are on this side of the room. All right, so let's walk in here. And they have some Northcott fabrics here. I love working with Stonehenge. And this is all the Northcott Stonehenge. You can see there's one, two, three, there's four racks of this stuff in this shop. Oh, this stuff is so cute. Because it's not like, it's kind of like a solid. It plays like a solid, right? They're tone on tone. And they have more like marbled looks, but it's still keeping with the same color. So I like that it adds another layer of texture and dimension to the project, but you're still like using kind of solids, you know? Super, super cute. These are Northcott. This is Northcott Toscana. You guys know I love to work with this stuff. And then the ones that have the metallic in it, that have like some more shimmer. Sandscapes. Pre-cuts of it. Oh my gosh, there's so much fabric. It's nuts. And this is like one side that I'm showing you guys. On the other side, it's like we've been missing an entire row of stuff. So there's solids here. Ooh, these look like linen or something. What is this stuff? Oh, it just looks like it. It's the print of it. So this stuff here is Weave by Moda. And so it's just in all the different colors, and it's pretty cool because it looks like it has a weave to it, but it's still just a solid, so really pretty stuff. All right, so let's keep walking and see what else they got around the corner. I know the cone is on the other wall. This stuff is the Free Spirit, the designer solids. So this is the Free Spirit. So they basically carry different manufacturers and their solids. That way, you know, you can match exactly what you need if you're looking for like a different little shade of teal or something. With these Free Spirit ones down there, they pretty much have all of them. And I love that color, but let's keep moving. So you all are cutting, you're cutting stuff for the online orders?
Yes, ma'am.
Yep. This is that cuddle, right?
Yep.
Shannon Fabrics cuddle fleece.
Yes.
That's definitely cuddle. So everybody's busy in here cutting stuff, and let me just show you guys around the other side of this. This is Michael Miller Fabrics on this side, and so like it's just separated out by manufacturers. You'll find stuff like basics that are not necessarily solids. So in here they have like all these different chevrons as well, all the different chevrons in pretty much every color. Oh, you're fine. Then you have all the different pre-cuts from the different manufacturers. So right here I'm looking at some solids by RJR. Some cool little 2.5-inch strips and stuff, different. So a lot of companies now are starting to do more of those pre-cuts. Here is your cuddle cake. So this is the 10-inch by 10-inch squares of the cuddle fleece that Shannon Fabrics puts out. Super soft stuff. Oh, these are gorgeous. What are these? Oh, this is Riley Blake Fabric. And this is like their solids. It kind of looks like that Moda weave thing that I was just showing y'all. They're called shade, basic shade, I guess. So they're really cute because they play like solids again, but they're not necessarily super solid. And here you have the cotton and steel basics that I talked about in that other shop. So they have some there. And then on this side, hey, look, it's Al. That's Jenny's son. I'm doing a video tour of all the shops with my new selfie stick, showing them what they can get in all the shops. All right, so on this side is all the Kona solids. Look at all these colors. Seriously, this is like nuts. Super, super cool. And it goes all the way down to the wall. And here we have all the Kona stuff going all the way down to the wall. So there are a lot of fabrics in here. A lot of solids, a lot of basics, things to kind of work into your different projects. And then there's so many quilts and projects that they already have on display to give you inspiration and ideas and things that you can use them in. All right, so let me show you the big sign that I told you was original to the shop. You see that shot, the sign behind me that says, let me move my head, JCPenney Company? They kept that in here, so they called it the Penny Store. Super cute. And I love this quilt that was done just in solids. So you guys gotta check this out. It's like right behind the checkout counter. Isn't that quilt gorgeous? All solids, super cute. How are y'all doing?
Good.
They got y'all busy cutting away.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so now I'm gonna walk through this little walkway here, and now we're in License to Sew. So this is the shop that has all the license prints in it, and that's stuff like your Disney prints, your things that are like a lot of novelty things, you know, like if you're making a quilt for somebody that likes cats, you know, you can come in here and find a whole section on fabric with cats, with dogs, with stuff like this. Team fabrics, baseball, football, college teams. This is all that kind of stuff. So all your novelty print fabrics, this is right here, you can see kind of like dump trucks and stuff, I guess for little boys with screws and hardware, stuff like that. You have a bunch of different things, but people come in here, I mean, they'll sell like frozen panels if they're still in stock, because you know those things go like crazy. Spider-Man fabric, Star Wars fabric, the Hungry Caterpillar fabric. Sports teams, right? They have animal print fabrics. And just like really fun stuff. You know, if you're looking for something with a specific theme, look at all these doggy fabrics to make dog projects or doggy beds or stuff for friends who have and love dogs. You know, things, if you're looking for themed prints, this is where you're gonna find the stuff in License to Sew. Let me see if I can find you some of the fun, geeky kind of, here we go, Star Trek. Hey, how are you?
Good, how are you?
good. Just doing a video tour of all the shops so I can upload it tonight. You're fine. So look at all this Spider-Man. Spider-Man that popular? Three whole things of Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Star Wars stuff. You can see there's like Captain America, the Avengers, all that kind of stuff is here. So if you're looking for this type of fabric and you can't make it to Hamilton, check out the website. Because again, they are in the shops cutting the same orders that people are placing online. So this is all their inventory. So here we have all the college football teams, baseball teams, basketball teams, all that kind of stuff. And then you have like generic prints of the sporting things. So a whole lot of stuff in here. Really cute stuff. All right. So that's License to Sew. Oh, look at the little minions up there. In the little car. And then a Frozen thing, of course, of Elsa and Anna. And this is where you have your Disney stuff. There is My Little Pony.
You get that one.
My Little Pony stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Frozen Prince, Princesses, Hello Kitty, Betty Boop stuff, Dr. Seuss, Mickey, Tinkerbell. Wow. Pokemon. Alright. Oh my gosh, how cute is this minion fabric? Are you kidding me? Okay, hold on. I'm gonna take a yard of this, so I'll be right back. My son is gonna love this. How cute is this little minion fabric? So sorry guys, had to stop for a quick fabric shopping break. I'm sure you all can understand. And this is Jenny. Hi, Jenny.
Hello.
She works here in the License to Sew shop. Cool.
For now.
Yeah. Once it opens. They said they're going to put it with the backing for now.
Yeah, I heard
that's
that.
That's cool, though, because, you know, they can't fill it up with one thing. It's cool to...
Exactly. And at least they'll get our feet wet selling some yarn and getting some knitting and crocheting going.
Awesome.
Not to mention, I can't wait to get
Well, you better
needles.
Crank out some samples.
Oh, I got tons.
Oh, you do?
I got tons.
Look at this little yellow one. So cute. Awesome. All right, now I'm done with fabric shopping. I will get back to the video tours. All right, so I got my son some minion fabric, and now let's keep going with the tour. Actually, this is the last shop. I think I've shown you all of them already. Work my way up here. It's kind of toasty out, but that's it. That's the tour of the shops. I showed you the main shop, the mercantile. Then we did the So Seasonal, the boutique, that's what it's called, the boutique store. Then we did the solids shop and the License to Sew. And that's it for the shops that they have right now, but there are some other things coming. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and that you'll put Visiting Missouri Star, it's so windy out here, you'll put Visiting Missouri Star Quilt Company on your bucket list of things to do. This is where we are, is Hamilton, Missouri. It's about an hour from Kansas City, so that's actually where I fly into. But that's it for now, and I'll see you all next time.